And let me know if you can see that, Kyle. Can you see that 4 keys to making a living writing?
I can.
Beautiful. Okay, so we're going to jump right in. And I have a question. So let's throw up this poll question, Kyle. Why are you here? What are you hoping to get out of this? And we've got three different answers that you can choose from. Kyle, remind me what those three answers are.
Those three answers are, well, I don't think those are the options we were looking for in the answer choices. I'm not sure if I'm a writer or not. I have a
Right.
book I want to write,
There we go.
or I have a book I've written and want to sell.
Right. So which one of these describes you? Are you here because you're, I'm not a writer, but I'm, thinking of using writing. I have a book and I want to sell it. I don't have a book, but I want to become a writer and I'm not sure what the path is to do that. Or maybe you're just curious. But of the three that best describe, you pick one of those. While you're doing that, let's do a little house cleaning. Again, welcome everybody. If you're just joining us, we're just getting started. You haven't missed much. We're just about to get into the teaching. And just a reminder, if you stick around to the very end, we're going to go for about an hour, depending on how long Q&A goes. We're going to have a free prize for everybody. That's a free downloadable resource that's going to help you get unstuck with your writing today. And if you have any questions or comments, again, you can use the chat box for that. If you want to connect with people afterwards, you make some great connections, and you're on Twitter, use the hashtag GoinsWebinar. You can also use that as, another channel to connect with people. I'd really encourage you to use the chat, but afterwards, use the hashtag GoinsWebinar. If there's any questions that we miss or whatever, I always go there after we're done and follow up with anybody that may have, some outstanding questions or comments or anything like that. So that's another way to connect with people. So let's go back to the poll results. What did people say, Kyle?
We had 28% said I'm not sure if I'm a writer or not. 48% said I have a book to write, and
Wow.
25% said that I've already written a book and I want to sell it.
Cool. I love that. Here's the good news, guys. Wherever you are in this journey, whichever one of those you chose, you're going to find something helpful and useful today in this free live training. So, how does that sound? My goal is for everybody to leave here with something new that they didn't know or some challenge to go do something that they haven't done before that's going to help close the gap between where you are and where you need to be in terms of making a living writing. Before we do that, just a few quick things. Here's my backstory. For those of you who don't know me, my name is Jeff. Several years ago, I had one of the most amazing years of my life. I started a blog in 2011, and then in 2012, I had this incredible year where I got 100,000 monthly blog readers to the blog. I published two books in 1 year, and I made $150,000 off of my writing, which was more than enough for me to quit my job. Chase this thing that was really a dream, but I never really thought could happen. And my wife was even able to quit her job and raise our newborn son, which was a dream of hers. And so, this happened in 2012. This was 4 years ago. And the question I get often is this: is it too late for me? And the answer is no, it's not too late. Not because I did it 5 years ago and I know, all the things, but because every single year I see hundreds of people. I teach hundreds of students in my Tribe Writers course who do this. They close the gap between where they are and where they need to be with their writing. They publish books. They start making money with their writing. They get thousands of readers, and they take those first important steps to becoming full-time writers. I see people make the switch every single year. It's incredible, and it's possible for you too. Now, I will say, it takes work. As one of our students, Sandy Kreps, Sandy's in the chat right now. She's part of our team. So everybody say hi, Sandy, in the chat. We'll be talking more about her later, telling some of her story. But as she says, it's work, but it's good work. And I love that. And why this works is because it's not just a bunch of ideas that I have. It's a proven process based on a study that I did really for years. I had eight failed blogs before I had my ninth blog that didn't fail. Eight blogs that had less than 100 subscribers, and then for some reason, the ninth one, it succeeded. And the difference between those eight blogs and the ninth blog is that I decided to learn what I didn't know. I decided to follow a proven process, find some guides, some people who could coach me and help me through the process, and I began to get unstuck. And so this is a proven process. I'm going to share with you the whole process. I'm not going to hold anything back. I'm even going to give you practical takeaways for you to do today. And if you do the work, I believe you're going to see the results. Results vary. Some things take longer for some people than others. Some of us have more free time. That's all true. But if you do the work, I'm confident you're going to see results. Now, at this point, you might be going, yeah, but this doesn't really, this sounds kind of too good to be true because, you know, like I don't have enough time. I don't have enough money. I don't have enough opportunity. Look, here's my challenge to you. Are you looking for a way or are you looking for an excuse? Because I believe whatever you're looking for, you're going to find. And so if you're looking for a way to succeed as a writer, you're probably going to find that. And at the same time, if you're looking for an excuse, those are easy to find too, right? Like we all, nobody has an abundance of time. Most of us don't have an abundance of money that we don't know what to do with. And most of us don't feel like we're incredibly lucky and we have opportunities that we don't deserve. If you're like me, you kind of look at the world and you go, well, I could never do what so-and-so did because ... They had this advantage. They knew these people. They lived in this city. And again, I think those things can be valid, but the question is, what are you looking for? An excuse or a way? And I want to offer you a way. And all I'm asking for during this webinar is that you would suspend your disbelief and judgment just for, you know, 30, 40 minutes, just kind of go, okay, I'm willing to consider something new, or I'm willing to consider that maybe there's something that I haven't tried yet, and give it a whirl, and, you know, just kind of try it on, and if it fits, great, keep it, and if not, that's fine, discard it. But can I, for this hour that we have together, can I challenge you to think some things that maybe you've never thought before, try some things that maybe you've never tried before, and believe that this could work? Because I believe that now is actually the best time to become a writer. My question, though, is, are you willing to do the work? Because if you're not willing to do the work, then it's not going to work. And so I would love, before we jump into this, I'd love for you to just write in the chat, I'm in, if you're willing to do the work. And all that means is I'm going to share four things with you and ask you to do four things, okay? And I just want you to be willing during this time, because this is a free webinar, and I want you to get your money's worth. And we're both giving our time to be a part of this. So the best thing that you could do is shut down any distractions, pull out something to take some notes with, and be willing to try some of these things. They're not hard things, but you're going to have to, you know, exert a little bit of effort. Again, if you do the work, you're going to see the results. Are you in? Kyle, I can't see the chat because I've got just my slides in front of me.
I can barely see the chat because it's a blur. You have a lot of people who are in.
Great. Awesome.
Tap is in. Dominique and Drew are both in, and about 500 other people.
Love that, Dominique. Love that, Drew. I'm excited to walk through this with you.
So Maria's in all caps.
Woo! All right. So what we're going to talk about here is we're going to talk about how you go from amateur to professional. When I first started writing, I asked a best-selling novelist, Stephen Pressfield, whom I had the opportunity to interview at one point, when does a writer become a writer? He said this. He said, you are when you say you are. It begins with this belief that you are a professional. You start thinking like it. You start acting like it. And lo and behold, people start treating you like it. So today I'm going to share with you the things that professional writers do, things that you can do today, because it's a mindset shift. It's a mindset shift that's followed by daily disciplines and habits. And if you start doing these things, you're going to start being treated like a professional. And guess what happens to professionals? They get paid. And so this is really the first step in the process. I'm going to share four keys you know, with you. But the first step is you got to make that mental shift. You guys said, I'm in. You've already taken the first step towards becoming a professional writer. So the first key is this. You have to have a clear message. It's not just about being good. It's about being clear. Clarity trumps perfection. It is better to be clear than it is to be perfect. I'll say that again. Better to be clear than it is to be perfect. So what does this mean? Well, it means, first of all, that you don't do what a lot of people say to do, which is to go choose a niche, to go pick, you know, some group of people that haven't been reached before and, you know, try to target them. First of all, that's not true because pretty much every group of people has been reached by someone. Second of all, what, you know, let's say you decide you want to, you're a dog sweater knitter and you want to reach other dog sweater knitters. and you start a blog about dog sweater knitting. And you do this for years and years and become the dog sweater knitting, which is hard to say, expert of the world. And then one day your dog dies, God forbid. Or you just lose passion for this interest. But now you're stuck with this empire of dog sweater knitters and you don't know what to do with it. And there's really no way to get out of it except to start from scratch and to do something else. And this is what a lot of bloggers and writers online do, is they just kind of jump from idea to idea to idea. This is not what great writers do. Great writers write with a worldview. Great example of this is Stephen King. Stephen King started out writing in the genre of horror, but he is a great writer. And because he's a great writer, at least he's effective to his audience, people read whatever he writes. He wrote a memoir on writing. He wrote a book on the assassination of JFK. He wrote a number of novels that were not horror novels under the pen name of Richard Bachman, including The Shawshank Redemption, which is like a mystery thriller kind of book. Different genres, and yet people who love him followed all of that stuff. This is his tribe. These are the people who resonate with his worldview. Why does it work? Because Stephen King isn't just chasing an audience, he's writing with a worldview. And his worldview is informed by where he's from, what he thinks about the universe, his own ideology of good and evil, and all of that fits into his writing. His characters sound similar in a lot of his books. A lot of them are from New England. There is a feel and flavor to everything that Stephen King writes. You're going to have to do the same. So every great writer has a worldview. The question then is, how do I find mine? How do I find my worldview and share it with the world? Well, I've got a very simple process for this. It begins by asking yourself the question, what wrecks me? What just can I not stand? What do I think is wrong with the world that I might actually have the solution to? And then you plug it into this little formula here. Every blank can or should blank. Very simple. Every blank can or should blank. Every person should recycle. Every stay-at-home mom can start an online business without neglecting her family. Every writer should have a worldview. These are opinions. These are perspectives. These are ways of viewing the world that not everybody agrees with. And that is where you must begin before you even think about building an audience, is you have to have a clear worldview that informs your writing and also lets the reader know what they're getting into. So within reading the first few sentences of a blog post or a book, people should be able to very clearly discern, I'm with this person or I'm not. This goes for fiction and nonfiction alike, because great fiction has worldviews. I mean, look at The Great Gatsby. There is a worldview in that book about, you could get everything that you thought you wanted in the world and it still not satisfy you. It still not save you. I mean, there's all kinds of meaning in that book, and that comes from a very particular perspective from F. Scott Fitzgerald, and frankly, his experience as a middle-class person, who kind of was living in this world of wealth. So every blank can or should blank. I want you to write that down and fill that out later. Remember, we're talking about amateurs and professionals. Amateurs confuse, professionals clarify. So I've got a question for you. Do you have 5 friends? Let's throw that poll question up there, Kyle. And these are, yeah. Sorry. These are 5 friends that you can email, that you can text, that you can send a message to on Facebook. Do you have 5 friends that you could reach out to today and get some feedback from them? Because I believe that finding your voice as a writer isn't about just writing what excites you. That's the fastest way to anonymity. It's about sharing a message that's going to resonate with other people. So you haven't found your voice until you found an audience. I'll say that again. You haven't found your voice until you found an audience, because great writing has to resonate with someone. So do we have the results of that poll just yet?
We do. 93% of these people have 5 friends.
Woo! All right. Hey, if you don't have 5 friends, leave a comment.
If you have 3 friends, you can count me and Jeff and change your answer.
Yeah. I mean, if you don't have 5 friends, in all seriousness, say, hey, I need to connect with some people on the chat. We've got hundreds of people here who are like-minded people who have similar worldviews and could be a part of your tribe, and you guys can connect with each other. I believe that every story of success is a story of community. So don't leave here without connecting with somebody in the chat. Seriously. Okay, so let's take the 5 friends that most of us have and let's email them and ask them to do one thing. Hey, can you describe me in 3 words? Very simple. Write this down. Hey, can you describe me in 3 words? That's the email that you're going to send your friends or text or whatever. And then you're going to do the same thing. You're going to make a list of 3 words describing yourself. If you're a writer, you're going to describe your writing voice. If you're a speaker, communicator, you just want to write down some things that you believe are true about you and the way that you spread your message. And then you just want to see how that resonates with people who know you. It doesn't matter if they know you're writing or not. It doesn't matter if they know that you're on this webinar or not. We just want to understand, where are we resonating with people? And if there's no resonance, if there's no overlap, the 3 words, and people can write sentences if they want, but just very quick, like minimum, just write, you know, 3 words or 3 phrases that you think best describe me. And what you're looking for, again, is, okay, how do I describe me? And then how do other people describe me? And is there a disconnect, or is there some area of resonance? And if there's a disconnect, then you've got to sort that out. But the bottom line is, what makes a writer great is not just, hey, here are all of my ideas, but which ideas, which pieces of their personality are resonating with people. So hang on to that. That's takeaway number one. Let's move to key number two. I'm going to move quickly because I want to have a lot of time for Q&A. Key number two is a powerful platform. And who here has heard this term before, right? Platform, platform, platform. We've all heard this. Who here knows that there's more than one way to build one? This, I think, was very surprising to me when I started studying best-selling authors and bloggers and speakers and writers, and I realized that there is more than one way to do this. At the same time, there's not like a million ways. I think there are five major ways to do this, that 99.9% of platforms fit into one of these categories, which I call platform personalities. So I'm going to share those with you right now, and then I'm going to ask you to pick one of these that best suits you. And just ahead of time, I'm going to tell you, you can't be all five. This is like college. You could try to major in five different things, but you'd never leave. So try to pick one that best describes you. The first platform personality is the journalist. This person builds his platform by asking questions. These people are just naturally curious. This is the only requisite that you need to be one of these things, to be a journalist, is to be curious. And these people tend to ask questions, and they build their platform not around having the answer, but around asking the right questions. A great example of this is Darren Rouse from ProBlogger.net. And Darren started a blog called ProBlogger over a decade ago with one question: can you make money blogging? And he didn't know the answer, but he asked enough experts, he tried enough experiments, and he shared everything that he was learning on his blog. And guess what? Over time, because he asked the questions, he became the answer. This is the power of the journalist. You don't have to be an expert for people to perceive you as an expert. You don't even have to position yourself as a know-it-all. You just have to ask the right questions, and that is the journalist. The second platform personality is the prophet. This is the person who builds their platform by telling the dirty, ugly, nasty truth. These people are truth tellers, and it doesn't matter if they're going to offend people. They have to tell the truth about anything and everything. The only requisite for this is you have to be a little dissatisfied with the status quo. Great example of this is Seth Godin, one of the most popular bloggers in the world. Seth basically every day writes little rants on his blog about things that are broken in the world. This could be in marketing or business. It could be in politics or education. It doesn't matter the setting. Seth is writing with a worldview, and his worldview is the system is broken, but we can fix it. That is the worldview of a prophet. The third platform personality is the artist. This person builds their platform, obviously, by creating art. And the only requisite for this is you've got to have an eye for beauty. You have to notice things that other people might miss in the world. Great example of this is Anne Voskamp, who has a blog called aholyexperience.com, H-O-L-Y. This is a spiritual blog. Anne's been doing this for years now, and basically on this blog, she writes prose poetry. And it is not practical advice on how to live a better life. It is an insight into her world as a woman who is a mom and the wife of a farmer living in the middle of rural Ontario, in the middle of nowhere, in what appears to be mostly a mundane life, not a lot of, you know, quote unquote exciting things happening. And yet the way she describes it, it's beautiful. And it helps us make sense of our own lives, which is the gift that the artist gives us. You artists out there, you help us understand our own lives better because you notice things that the rest of us miss. The fourth is the professor, and this is a person who builds their platform on the facts. These people are obsessed with data, getting it right, and they want to know how everything works. The only requisite for this is you got to love to learn. You have to have a thirst for knowledge. Great example of this is Michael Hyatt. Go to michaelhyatt.com and try to find a blog post where he's not teaching you something. You can't do it because this is what professors do. They're always teaching. And Michael is a best-selling author, a speaker, a very popular online teacher. He calls himself the virtual mentor, and that is exactly what he is. He's always teaching. What professors do so well is they accumulate a lot of information, they digest it, and then they sort of synthesize it and then share it with you in a way where it's much easier to follow and apply. And so what professors do best is they take the complex and they make it simple. That's the professor. The fifth and final platform personality is the star. This is a person who builds their platform on their charisma. These people are just so darn likable. They're well known for having great personalities. And the reason that they're so likable is because they like people. The only requisite is you've got to have a heart for people. A great but perhaps unlikely example of this is Anne Lamott. Anne is a very popular memoir writer. And whether you read her one of her great books like Bird by Bird or go to her Facebook page and read, you know, she writes about once a week, kind of these daily rants, they're almost like blog posts. What she's doing time and time again is she's in a very funny, self-effacing way. She's saying, hey, if I got through this, you can get through that, which is the worldview of a star. They're almost like human guinea pigs. So it's not about being a superstar, a celebrity. It's about attracting people to a certain personality so that you can reflect back on them their own lives. And so memoir writers are this way. Tim Ferriss is actually this way. He always calls himself a human guinea pig. Anybody who's basically using themselves as sort of the hero of the story, but they're doing it in a way where it's like a proxy for the audience and saying, if I did this, you can do this. If I lost 10 pounds, you can lose 10 pounds. If I started a business, you can start a business. These people tend to be self-effacing, have very likable personalities, and people go, wow, like, if they did that, I can do that. I want to be that person, and I feel like I actually could. That's the star. So, question. Let's throw up this poll, Kyle. Yep. I asked you to pick one of these. Which one are you? And remember, you have to pick one. Think of it like a coat. Just try it on. You know, you're not going to put five coats on all at once. Try it on. See, you know, how it fits, and see if it works. But I want you to commit to one. And if you need two, think of one as a primary one and one as a secondary one. For me, really my primary platform personality is the prophet. And if I had to have a secondary one, I'd probably call myself the journalist. But at the end of the day, what I'm trying to do is tell the truth about whatever. Say, hey, you may have been lied to about this. Here's what actually works. So pick one of those, and it'll be interesting to see who chose what.
Yeah, and if you don't know which one you are, pick one you'd like to try.
Yeah, good call. Cool. So those results are rolling in. Let me know when we're ready to share those, Kyle.
I can tell you where we're at right now if you're ready.
Yeah.
We have, they're fluctuating a little bit, but we have 10 to 11% are saying journalist. I see 16 to 17% saying prophet, 25% artist, 25% professor, and 21% star.
It's so interesting. We've done this a number of times now, and there's no right answer, obviously, but like depending on the time of day and who's, you know, part of the webinar, you know, we've had a lot of stars and then very few, a lot of professors and very few. So it's pretty cool. So yeah, that's interesting. Okay. Again, there's no right or wrong answer. We're talking about amateurs and professionals. Amateurs wait to be discovered. They just kind of share their art with the world. They do their stuff. They put it out there and they wait for somebody to come find it. That is not going to work. If you're doing that, you need to stop doing that. Because what professionals do is they build a unique platform around their particular personality. They don't worry about their weaknesses. They focus on their strengths, and they have a very focused message. Somebody recently asked me, hey, you know, if I have lots of different things that I like, should I start multiple blogs for different personalities? No, not yet anyway. Don't start two blogs until you've succeeded at one. So pick one platform personality, own that, and here's the assignment for you. Pick a platform personality and commit to it for the next 30 days. Try it on and just, like I said, think of it like a coat. Putting five coats on all at once, you're going to be too hot. So put one on, try it for 30 days, and if you don't like it, bring it back and get a new one. But I want you to try this and commit to this. Remember I said, do the work and you're going to see the results. Part of the reason we don't see the results is because we never actually commit to any decisions. We try all the different things. We hear everybody say, do this, do that. Try all the different things. Then we go, none of this worked. It's because you didn't commit to a specific path. So try this. It works. I've seen it work thousands of times. Try it. Okay, so that's the second key. Powerful platform. The third key, we're halfway done, guys, is you got to have a committed tribe. Okay, a tribe is people. So if a platform is the way that you begin to connect with an audience, we're going to talk about tools and technology soon, guys, so don't worry about that. But we have to talk about the principles first before we talk about the tools and tactics that we're going to implement. A tribe is people. A platform is how you connect with those people. They're inseparable. If you have a platform, if you have a blog or a website or something, and you don't have an audience, you haven't really built a platform. I mean, really what you have is an empty stage. People aren't listening to you. That's all you've got. And we need to fill that stadium. We need to get people in front of you, get you an audience, so that when you get on that stage and share your message, people are listening and they're ready to take action. How do you do that? The best way to do it is to build an email list. Forget everything that you've heard about social media and all that stuff. Set that aside. That stuff's fine. But right now, this is the most important part. An email list is an essential part of any online business or serious platform. You have to have an email list. What's more, is it is the most universal way that you can communicate with most people online. When I say email list, I'm not talking about your Outlook contacts or your Rolodex or the people that you could email one by one. I am talking about people who have opted in to an email newsletter from you, something where you say, I'm going to send out daily blog updates, monthly updates on our business, whatever it is. Somebody gave you permission to communicate with them on a regular basis, not you got somebody's business card, you know, in a jar sometime. So why do we do this? Because everybody has an email address. It is the most universal way that you can communicate with the most amount of people online. Not everybody's on Twitter. A lot of people are. Not everybody's on Facebook. A lot of people are. But almost everybody you talk to has an email address, and most people are checking that regularly. Some people are checking their email 5 times a day. Others are checking it once a week. But everybody's got an email address, and if you could only get one thing from everybody, it should be an email. So just very clearly, I want to be clear here. If you don't have an email list, you haven't built an audience yet, and it's so easy, guys. So if you haven't done this, you need to do this. And there's three simple principles that'll help you succeed at growing a successful email list. First thing, you've got to give away something for free. Now, this can be an article series, a chapter of your book, a PDF. It doesn't really matter what it is. What matters is that it's generous and interesting. Okay? It has to be something that adds value to other people's lives. If you have questions about that, we'll talk about it in the Q&A. Second, you've got to give something new to your audience every week. What I mean by that is create a piece of content. Again, this can be whatever you want. It can be a video update, a newsletter, a blog post. The format doesn't matter so much as you've got to be creating and sharing something new with your audience every single week. Don't worry about doing it every day or 3 times a day or any of that stuff until you have successfully shared something with an audience once a week, every week, without fail for 90 days. Then you can increase the the frequency from there. But a lot of people go, I'm going to blog every day. And then 3 days in, or maybe 3 weeks in if you're lucky, you kind of fizzle out. Every week I send an email newsletter with a new blog post to my audience of nearly 200,000 people. And it works. It doesn't need to be any more complicated than that. And this is my full-time job. So I would send more. I have more time to send more stuff, but people don't need more stuff. You don't need more clutter in your inbox, but you do need more helpful information. And coming up with one piece of helpful content for your audience is something that we can all do. Free, ask people to share. This is important and overlooked for a lot of reasons. One, people think it's self-promotional. Two, we just don't think about it. We don't think that if we created something, other people might want to share it. And there's lots of different ways that you can do this. You can do it on Twitter using a tool called clicktotweet.com. You can embed those in your email newsletters and people will start tweeting links to your blog for you just by saying, hey, was this helpful to you? Click here and people click it and it'll automatically create a tweet that sends a link or whatever you want out to people on Twitter. So all of a sudden you've activated this little street team that can start, you know, telling people about what you're doing. That's a free tool called Click to Tweet. You can ask other bloggers to link to your content. This is something that I love doing when somebody shares helpful, interesting, useful content with me. I love sharing with other people. Or lastly, you can just ask people receiving an email to forward it to a friend. It's something we all do. And when somebody asks you to do it and it was helpful, you go, well, yeah, that makes sense. This is not self-promotional. This is not sleazy. If I give you something for free, right, and I say, hey, did this help you? And you go, yeah, great. Can you go help somebody also for free with the thing that I helped you for free with? That's not self-promotional. That's generous. You're empowering people to be generous. It's a powerful thing. And if you're actually creating generous and interesting content, people will want to share it. But sometimes you've got to ask them, and they go, oh, yeah, I'm happy to do that. This is how you're going to grow your tribe. If you do this, you will build an audience. And a tribe, I quantify, like once you've kind of reached your critical mass, you have to have 1,000 true fans. You have to have 1,000 subscribers who are listening to what you have to say, who are opening your emails, paying attention to your message. At that point, you can start making a serious living off of that. That is the first major inflection point, 1,000 true fans. So remember, this is not about self-promotion. It's not about being pushy. It's about helping people. Whether you write fiction, memoir, nonfiction, business writing, you're a video blogger, whatever it might be, it is not about who you know that is going to help you build a tribe. It's about who you help. And as Zig Ziglar once said, if you help enough people get what they want in life, you don't have to worry about what you want in life because enough people are going to help you get what you want. It's just this sense of reciprocity. If you put enough good things out into the world, good is going to come back to you. I know that sounds a little bit woo-woo, but it's true on a very practical level. What do you want your reputation to be? Do you want to be the person who's running around asking for things, or do you want to be known as the person who's running around giving? And if you do that enough times, people start talking about you. Your reputation precedes you because you're a good, nice person. So this is how you begin to grow a tribe. Amateurs want to write for themselves, but professionals serve their tribe. They help their audience. Even if it starts with those 5 people that you need to email, you've already got the beginnings of a platform. Now you just need to grow it. And it's just helping people, guys. It's very simple. If you've got particular questions about this, we'll talk about it in the Q&A. You cannot move forward. All great writers I know, all successful working writers I know have an email list. They just do. And so if you don't have an email newsletter service sending out emails for you, let's fix that today because that is a really important thing. So here's your takeaway. Very simple. Create a website. Pick an email service provider. If you don't have a website, you can get one for free, or you can spend $3 a month and have your own domain name, like goinswriter.com. And you can get an email service provider for the next 30 days absolutely for free. Here are 2 links you can write down if you don't have those things. If you need a blog, go to goinswriter.com/launch-blog. Follow the instructions there to get you set up there. And you can go to goinswriter.com/convertkit. To get 30 days free email marketing service. It's absolutely free. That's a paid service, but you get the first 30 days for free. You can try it out and see if it works for you. If you have any trouble with this kind of stuff, in Tribe Writers, we help people navigate that stuff. I'll share more with you about that at the end. But this is something that we help people get set up with so that they can start focusing on their content. They don't have to worry about all of the technology. So that was the third key. Here's the fourth and final key, income. You've got to have income. Professionals get paid, and it's not just enough to get paid once. Professionals keep getting paid every single month, every single year. And most working writers I know have diverse streams of income. But before you even begin to diversify your income, you've got to start with a small win that then becomes a bigger win and a really big win. And so I mentioned at the very beginning that there was a year where I made $150,000 in a year, and that was 2012. I want to share with you how I did that exactly. Would that be helpful to you? Because I did all this work leading up to this point, and I still wasn't making money. I had an idea of what my message was and how to focus it and who I was going to help with it. And I started growing an email list, and I got to 1,000 email subscribers. And then I got to about 10,000 email subscribers in the first year. And I had spent the first year giving away a ton of stuff, to the point that people were emailing me asking, can I buy something from you? And I didn't have anything to sell. And then I met this person who kind of coached me through this process. And like I said, it's not enough to just try different things. You've got to follow a proven process, and it's good to have a guide or a coach to lead you through the process. And I had somebody do that for me. And here's what she told me. First, you have to identify your expertise. Okay, so you have a six-figure business on your hand, she said, and you haven't maximized your opportunity. And the reason is because you're still kind of unclear about what you have to offer. So first, identify your expertise. And I love how Derek Sivers says this. What's obvious to you is amazing to others. So ask yourself the question, what's obvious to me? What do I take for granted? Don't worry about the amazing just yet. Just find something that's obvious to you. Make a list of things that are obvious to you that could be helpful to other people. Then ask your audience. If you just have those five friends, that's your audience right now, go ask those people. But ask somebody, because the idea here is you don't want to guess what they want. You want to ask them. Very simple, but overlooked. The way I did this was by doing a survey. And a survey is just a fancy word for you ask people some questions, and then you look at the answers later. So you can do this for free through Google. They've got a free survey service. You can do it through SurveyMonkey, or you can just email the people the questions and look at the answers. First question, how can I better help you? Very simple. People told me you can help me figure out how to build a blog. Oh, okay. And then I said, if I created something for sale, would you buy it? Lots of people said yes. And then I said, okay, how much do you want to pay? And people told me, and they said, look, we'll pay anywhere from $5 to $20 for you to create some sort of PDF ebook that helps us become full-time writers and become better bloggers based on the experience that you've had. And I thought, okay, like I can do that. Like that's within my wheelhouse. I've done this, and I can tell people, how I did this. So here's the last step. Give them what they want. This is important. Like at this point, it's not about having to sell anything. It's just about giving it to them. You don't have to make people pay you, but you do have to let them. And the way I did this was by putting together a $2.99 ebook, which I sold 500 copies of in the first 48 hours. I made $1,500. And then from there, I took what I learned from that. A few months later, I launched another product, which was a book, a self-published ebook. And I made $15,000 off of that in 6 weeks. And a little bit later, I launched a course based on that book. Same product, same idea, just a different articulation of it. I made $25,000, then $36,000. And on it went until at the end of the year, I'd made $150,000. But all of that happened in about a six-month period. I had spent 8 years struggling as a writer just to try to figure this stuff out. And then I met a guide, a mentor, who helped me understand the process that I was sort of stumbling through and helped me understand what to do next. And I made $150,000 in 6 months. Needless to say, it was incredible. But since then, things have only gotten better and better. So here's my question for you. And let's throw this poll up, Kyle.
You bet.
Do you have an expertise worth sharing? Do you have an idea, a story to tell, a message to share? I don't care if people are listening right now. I care if you think it's worth sharing. Because what we're talking about here is how you begin to make a living writing. And at the end of that year, it changed our lives. $150,000 is an incredible amount of money. It tripled our household income. My wife quit her job. I quit my job. I launched this business. I became a full-time writer, and I've been doing it ever since. And every year, we've grown as a business. We've done better and better work, and it's a ton of fun. But at the very beginning, if you would have told me that I could do this, I wouldn't have believed you. But remember, I said, if you do the work, you're going to see the results. And at the very end of that year, my wife threw a party. for me when my second published book came out and gave me a card, and it said, it was never a question of if, but always a matter of when. And that's true for you too. It's not a question of if, it's a matter of when. If you're willing to do the work, and it begins by believing that you have something to offer. So what are the results of that say, Kyle?
We have, I was answering a question. 89% of people do believe they have an expertise worth sharing, and 11 people say they're not sure.
Cool. Totally understandable. Like I said, I wasn't sure. It's okay to not be sure. What I want to challenge you to do is take the next step. Trust the process. I have given you the process. I have given you these four things that you can go do tomorrow. And try it and see if you see results. Try some of these things and see if you see results. If not, okay, well, don't do it. But my challenge to you is to pick one process, commit to it. Try to get a guide or someone to help you so that you can begin to take the next steps that you need. Because, you know, we're talking here for 30, 40 minutes. We can't solve all of your problems in this time, but we can help you get unstuck and take the very next step. So what does that look like specifically? What the next step is, I think for a lot of people, is Seth Godin says, don't wait for people to pick you. Pick yourself, because nobody's going to pick you. You're going to have to pick yourself. I think the next step for a lot of us is to do what Sandy Kreps did. This is Sandy. Sandy's in the chat right now. Everybody say hi, Sandy. She's a rock star. I'm going to share with you what she did. This is a little bit more of a down-to-earth example than my, you know, crazy $150,000 in 6 months story, which is great and doable, and I've seen people replicate that and exceed it. But Sandy is somebody who is in the trenches right now. She's not on the other side of it. She's working through it, and she is having some really great, inspiring success. So here's what Sandy has done. I almost said candy. Here's what Sandy has done recently. She's published 2 books on Kindle, built an email list of 1,200 subscribers, and she launched her first print book. Her first print book is called Mommy Simplicity. You go to Amazon right now and buy it, read all the great reviews on it. It's doing great. It launched in January of this year, and here's what the sales look like. 76, 298, these are monthly sales numbers, 83, 77, 75, 53, 45, 38, 65, 94. That adds up to 904 books. Sandy is on her way to selling 1,000 copies of this book. And if you can sell 1,000 copies of a book, you can sell 10,000 copies, because this is 1,000 is a huge number. And once you get to 1,000 email subscribers, you can get to 10,000. Once you get to 1,000 books, you can get to 10,000. Sandy is on her way to becoming a full-time professional writer. In addition to the book sales, she's making over $1,000 a month off of her writing. That's not like astronomical, mind-blowing success, but who would say no to an extra $1,000 a month? It's possible if you do what Sandy did. What Sandy did, she said the difference was between kind of struggling and succeeding is she took this online course that I've been telling you about, Tribe Writers, which I shared with you a lot of the process. She took this course, she trusted the process, and she saw the results. Here's what she said. Before I joined Tribe Writers, I felt like I was getting nowhere. I was trying different stuff and nothing was working. I felt like I was making up the plan as I went along. There was no plan. It was just me sitting in front of the computer each day going, well, now what? I had no email list, few readers, and I felt like I was talking to myself most days. Can you relate to that? Now, after taking Tribe Writers, she said, I feel confident. I have a plan. I know what to do and I'm not overwhelmed anymore. Plus, I have a great community of writers to bounce ideas off. Do what Sandy did. Find a trusted guide, find a proven process, and a community of writers who will support you. Tribe Writers is a great place for that. If you don't do that, find something else. But just give me a second. Let me share with you a little bit why Tribe Writers might be a good fit for you. What is it? Well, it's an online membership site. So you buy access to it, you get a login, and you get to log in and go through all of this content whenever you have time to do that. You pay a one-time fee. You get lifetime access to these video teachings that we give you. It's an 8-week course, and the 8-week process is made up of 4 modules. The first module is honing your voice, is where we help you focus your message, figure out your worldview, start communicating clearly. Remember, that's the first key. The second is we are going to walk you through blogging and establishing your platform and figuring out which platform personality you are and how to apply it to your writing, and then how to start building a blog around everything that you're doing. The third is expanding your reach. This is where we talk about email list building, getting your 1,000 subscribers, and then even how to use social media and networking and guest posting, all kinds of great tools that'll help you on your way. We walk you through the process to do that. The fourth module is about getting published and paid and start making $1,000 a month as a writer. This is not the end, but this is your first small win. Remember, I made $1,500, and then a few months later, I made $15,000. By the end of the year, I made $150,000. These small wins have a way of becoming big wins. And our first small win for you is 1,000 subscribers and $1,000 a month off of your writing. It is possible for anybody here. So, of course, the question is, what does it cost? Well, it doesn't cost what it would cost to basically rent my brain for a day. I do a little bit of small group coaching with high-end clients. That costs about $15,000 a day. It doesn't cost what my exclusive small group mastermind costs, which is $5,000 to be a part of, to be in a group coaching process with me. It doesn't even cost $2,500, which you know, is what a lot of online courses are costing these days. Tribe Writers cost $59 a month, or $99 a month. And that's a 12-month payment plan, or you can pay in full and save about 20%. What you get with the student membership, the $59 a month plan, is you get 8 weeks of content, private forum access, limited email support, and 2 group coaching calls with me. The premium membership is $99 a month. You basically get double all that stuff for not double the price. You get all of that plus 30-day unlimited support with us, and then limited support after that. But you can email me and my team, and we'll answer any question within 24 hours. 4 bonus case studies, 4 group coaching calls, and 1 private 15-minute coaching call with me. Just you and me on the phone. I will help you get unstuck. And just this time, we're doing this new thing where in February, I'm going to have a live event. And if you want me to teach you this in person, you can sign up for Tribe Writers Live. This is a we're limiting this to 30 people because that's kind of the max capacity that we have. You can come to Franklin, where I live, Franklin, Tennessee, and I will teach you this in person. If you're too busy to go through the course, you just want some, you know, more in-person interaction with 29 other people. We'll buy your lunch. This is February 4th and 5th, and you'll get 6 months of support after that. Plus, you'll get the premium course. That's $199 a month, or $19.97 if you want to pay in full. That's not for everybody, obviously, because we only have 30 spots, but it's a good option as well. So, like I said, it's as little as $59 a month. My question for you is this. If all this course did for you was allowed you to do what Sandy did, would it be worth it? I want you to give me honest feedback, because I have spent years, hundreds of hours building this thing and rebuilding it. We're on our second version of the course. Every couple of years, I go back through it and I redo all of it. I just want this to be the best thing for you. If all it did was allow you to do what Sandy did, would it be worth it? Yes or no? Let's recap exactly what that would mean. If you could clarify your message, launch your platform, get 1,000 subscribers, and start making $1,000 a month for as little as $59 a month, would it be worth it? Yes or no? Kyle, what do you think? Would it be worth it?
It'd be worth it for me.
Anybody else saying yes?
Oh, yeah.
It's always awkward to put myself at the mercy of the audience.
Yeah, it's been crickets, Jeff. I'm sorry to tell you. We've seen a lot of no's. No, I'm kidding. Hundreds of yeses.
Amazing. Okay, cool. Well, I just want to make, for those of you that this could be helpful for, by the way, we're going to get to Q&A in just a second. I just want, you know, I want to make it a no-brainer. So can I just give you some more stuff for free? Is that okay? If you sign up on this webinar, we're going to give you 2 bonuses. You'll get a $100 discount. Use the code in all caps webinar. So you get $100 off of those prices I just shared with you. And you're going to get another free course on how to launch a blog called Intentional Blog. This is a $200 course. We sell this every day for $197. You're going to get it with Tribe Writers for free. We are not doing this next time we launch Tribe Writers, which won't happen until May. So this is an opportunity to get something that you will not get for free again. And if you are one of the first 10 people to buy on the call today, I'm going to give you a bonus one-on-one call with me for 15 minutes, where it's just you and me on the phone, and we will talk through any problem, questions that you have, whatever you want. In fact, we'll get on video chat, and we'll talk face-to-face if you want. That's just for the first 10 people who buy. I'm going to give you the link. These tend to go pretty quickly. So if you're in, you're ready to buy for as little as $59 a month. If you buy at any level, you're going to get one of these coaching calls for free. If you buy at the premium level, you're going to get two because you already got one with the membership, and you'll get a bonus one if you're one of the first 10 people to buy. Okay, so just to recap real quick, here's what you get if you get Tribe Riders, and then we'll move to Q&A. An 8-week video course, live coaching calls, email support, forum access, $600 in webinar bonuses that I just shared with you, plus 500 other bonuses that I didn't even mention because I want to get to your questions, but we can talk more about that if you want to know what those are. So I'm going to give you the link. We're going to throw this up. If you want one of those 10 spots, they're going to go quickly. Kyle will tell you when we're sold out of those, and we're going to answer as many questions as we can. So let's go ahead and share that link in just a second, Kyle. Here's my guarantee. If you take the course for 30 days, you do the work, you don't see any results, I'll just give you your money back. You just have to send me an email, fill out a form, say, I did the work. Here's how I prove I did the work. It didn't work for me. Okay, here's your money back. I don't deserve to keep your money if I can't help you. So there's the link. We'll go to Q&A. We have about 15 minutes for that. I will turn my video back on, and I will answer as many questions as I can. Remember, those coaching calls are going to go quickly. So if you're thinking about it, I will go ahead and do it. It's $59 a month. There's a money back guarantee. I'm taking all the risk. I think it's a no-brainer, but I'll leave that up to you.